When prepping for long-term SHTF-style scenarios, you have to choose what your preps and equipment are made out of in the sense of material. And when it comes to things like sheaths and holsters, you have a lot of options, but the main two options are gonna be leather or kydex, aka some kind of polymer. And in this video, we're gonna discuss which one might be a better choice for long-term SHTF scenarios due to the characteristics of both materials. Hey everybody, it's Magic Prepper, and today we're talking about leather versus kydex for SHTF, long-term survival, dependability, and durability of the materials that these different holsters and sheaths, belts, whatever it may be, are made of, and how long it's gonna last you, and whether or not one is a better option for a long-term situation, okay? Basically, they both have a lot of reliability, they both have a great track record, and there's a lot of reasons why you might choose one over the other. And in this video, I'm gonna help you narrow down those choices so you can make a better and more informed decision for yourself in the sense of being better prepared for some kind of a long-term scenario where you might not be able to access additional holsters or sheaths or belts in the future, okay? And if you're worried about being prepared for said long-term scenario, then hit the subscribe button below because hopefully I can bring this information to the forefront and give you some more ideas and better options as to how to be better prepared for yourself, okay? So, first and foremost, leather. It's a material made from tanning or chemically treating animal skins. It's organic. It is skin that has been treated, okay? Obviously, that's what leather is. Now, what are the pros of leather? And obviously, right here, I have a nice leather belt set up with a leather holster and a leather knife sheath because this is one of my classy rigs, is what I like to call it. For obvious reasons, leather is beautiful. And this is a really nice Galco rig with a really nice Topps knives sheath here. And I don't know, I really like it. Is it the best option? Well, let's talk about it. So it's pliable, okay? Leather is pliable and it still retains its rigidity. And what that means is that it has flexibility to it. It's not so rigid that if it is to get squashed under something, it doesn't mean it's gonna break. It has the flexibility to be a little bit more durable in the sense of dealing with things that are gonna put pressure on it, okay? So thousands of years of proven reliability when it comes to leather. Leather has been a staple in the sense of holsters and sheaths and scabbards and belts and all kinds of retaining devices over the centuries because mankind has utilized leather for that long. So the idea and the process behind crafting leather for said purposes is enormously huge when it comes to the wealth of knowledge related to it. And there's a lot of wisdom and a lot of information based on how to make leather the best you can for said purpose. So there's a lot of wealth of knowledge there sitting back behind thousands of years of innovation to make leather perform the way it does now. Now keep in mind, one of the things you'll hear a lot in the sense of survival and prepping is that you can eat leather. Don't eat this leather. This leather has been tanned or chemically treated, which means whatever you're eating in the sense of the leather is going to go inside of your body and probably poison you in one way or another. And you'll get sick, and having an upset stomach is much worse than having an empty stomach in an SHTF scenario. So I wanted to mention that because I know someone in the comments down below is going to mention that you can eat leather. And you should not eat leather that's been tanned or chemically treated because now you're eating all of that and it's gonna ruin your insides and you're gonna need a crap load of Pepto-Bismol. So, what else is great about leather? Well, it's repairable. In the field, leather can be repaired more easily than things like kydex or other polymers. Once it's torn or ripped or has a gash or whatever caused the damage, you can technically repair it in the sense of basically sewing it back together. Now, is it going to work as well as it did before? Of course not. But is there the capability to at least put in some kind of primordial, primitive style repairs on a leather holster or a leather sheath? Yes, there is. So there are ways you can repair it and maintain its functionality even if it does become damaged, which I would say is a benefit to a long-term survival situation, okay? So the other thing is that leather is beautiful. This is one of its pros. It looks gorgeous. And because of it being so classy and gorgeous and having that style of look to it, it remains a little bit more gray man than your kydex or your polymer holsters or sheaths or belts because people look at it as being a normal part of life, basically. If you're wearing a leather belt, people don't look twice at it. But if you're wearing a nylon belt with a metal retainer that is made for carrying a holster, it has a little bit more of an attention draw to it. So that being said, leather allows you to be a little bit more under the radar. Even if you're carrying a firearm or a knife or whatever it might be, there's a look to leather that makes it seem like you're just a classier person who's just minding their own business versus some tactical douchebag. Right? Although we like that guy sometimes. So there is that level of benefit to leather as well in the sense of optics, but it can biodegrade because it is organic, it's skin, and it takes about 50 years for that to happen. So in reality, is that really a con? No, it's still a pro because 50 years of use out of something, as long as it's well maintained, is a long, long time. So I don't necessarily think that its biodegradability is actually an issue, but I wanted to bring that up. So what are the cons of leather? What's the problem with using leather for a long-term SHTF scenario? Well, it absorbs water, which is a huge one, okay? You are going to get wet if you're in an SHTF situation, okay? There's a good chance of it happening, especially if you're out in the elements, if it's gonna rain, if you have to forge a river or whatever it might be, you're going to get wet. And when it gets wet, it absorbs water. And when it absorbs water, it can deform and cause problems and takes forever to dry. And that's one of the biggest cons to leather in the sense of long-term durability. It absorbs water and there's water everywhere. So if you don't expect to ever get wet in an SHTF event, okay, maybe it's not an issue for you. But in general, I think especially when you're talking about long-term bug out situations, things where you have to rely on the equipment you have on your body and only that equipment for who knows how long, is that something you're really worth taking the risk on in the sense of getting wet? Because most likely you will, okay? It can become deformed, and once it becomes deformed, it might not be useful anymore. If you can no longer put the knife back in the sheath, then what kind of a sheath do you have anymore? Is it even useful to have on you? Or is it just extra weight for no reason at that point? These are things you have to consider when it comes to leather, okay? It also requires routine maintenance in the sense of conditioning. You have to condition leather to be able to put up with the elements and for it to survive long term and last as long as it can. Yes, there are leather holsters from back in the early 1900s that still function right now that you can find at thrift stores and antique shops and in museums that really will still do the job of a holster. But were they well maintained? Were they kept out of the elements? Were they stored properly? I doubt that those are the leather holsters that were worn in the middle of island hopping in the Pacific and are covered in salt water and exposed to sunlight on a regular basis. So these are things you need to consider. Yes, with proper maintenance, that leather holster can last you a lifetime. But are you able to properly maintain a leather holster or a leather sheath or a leather belt in the middle of an SHTF scenario? Are you gonna carry leather conditioner with you in order to be able to maintain the properties of your holster or sheath or belt during that situation, or is that just extra dead weight? These are considerations you have to make when it comes to choosing what kind of material you're gonna go with. And like I said, leather has a lot of pros, but it also seems to have a lot of cons. Now, let's talk about kydex. Or when we say kydex, generally we're not talking about actual kydex, because kydex is actually a registered trademarked material that is specifically a certain type of thermoplastic. Whereas a lot of what we see on the market now is referred to as kydex because it's just a universal term now for polymer or plastic when it comes to sheets and holsters. But generally they're just some sort of nylon filled or glass filled nylon plastic that similarly molds to heat like kydex does, so people generally label it kydex. So in general, what we're really talking about is polymers because most of them have similar properties and are gonna have the same level of cons and pros as kydex would. So is this holster right here actual kydex? No, but is it of similar properties and of similar durability and reliability? Of course it is. And same with this knife sheath right here. This is not kydex, but it's also not leather, okay? This is also another polymer. So that's just something I wanted to mention really quickly, but the idea remains the same, okay? So as long as you purchase from a quality manufacturer that uses polymers for their products, you're gonna get the same level of quality you expect from a kydex actual material used holster or sheath, okay? So just make sure you're buying from quality manufacturers. If you're just buying from some random Etsy shop, who knows exactly what you're getting, but these are things you need to consider because we don't wanna just buy low quality polymers because those will have more problems than things that are put out by quality manufacturers, okay? So what are the pros of kydex, which we'll just say as a universal term for polymer, just to make things a little bit easier and more understandable, okay? Well, it's extremely durable, okay? And it's completely waterproof. It does not absorb water. It's not going to cause problems if it's exposed to water. And like I said, it's very durable. It is super strong, and it's very hard to break anything made out of kydex. So these are things you need to consider because the durability is through the roof. And there is no biodegradation of kydex. This is a polymer, man-made material that really has no reason to ever fall apart or dissolve into nothingness. So it's molded to the exact shape of the tool to be carried as well, which I find to be highly beneficial because it's not some kind of a loose science in order to make sure it fits a certain type of firearm or knife that you're trying to put inside of the holster or sheath. It is exactly tailored to your specific model and even models that might have certain accessories to make sure that they are really tight fitting and have really strong retention, which is important for security. And that creation of like an audible click and that secure retention is another huge pro of using kydex for your holster or sheath needs. Because knowing that your tool of choice is properly stored and not gonna just fall out or be taken from you in many cases is very important in an SHTF event. And kydex holsters or polymer holsters, like this one from Safariland right here, has a actual locking mechanism on it, which is another way to have better security to make sure that you remain safe during a disaster scenario and that somebody can sneak up on you and take what you have or whatever it is. Your choice needs to be made on that whole situation regarding security levels of holsters, but these are just other options that kydex or polymer style holsters offer that you don't get with leather. Yes, there's thumb straps and snaps and all kinds of stuff, but they don't have the same security functions as some of these AOS style mechanisms do, okay? So, wanted to bring that to your attention. And the other thing about kydex is that it does not deform unless it's completely and utterly neglected. If you completely neglect your polymer or your kydex holster or sheath, and you leave it out in the sun in a 150 degree hot box of a vehicle in direct sunlight in a dash that's completely black and absorbs all the heat possible, then yes, it might deform. But other than in those rare situations, you're not gonna have to worry about any kind of deformity happening. Whereas with leather, it can happen very easily just from absorbing too much water and not being able to dry properly. So these are other things to consider, okay. So, what are the cons to kydex? Why would polymer be a bad choice for SHTF long-term survival and durability? Well, one of the biggest cons to kydex is that if it breaks, there's really no way to fix it properly. In the field especially, we're not talking about having a full workshop, we're not talking about having access to a heat gun or anything like that. We're talking about being out in the field, long-term, post-apocalypse, everything's gone to hell, and you're relying on your equipment and only your equipment. Fixing a kydex holster is not really an option if it cracks or if it breaks. And when they break, they actually break for the most part because they're very strong, very durable. So if you do something or something happens out of the ordinary that causes that sheath or that holster to crack or break, you're not gonna be able to fix it. You can't just tape it back together. You'll lose all your retention. It'll no longer be safe and you really won't be able to use it. So that's a huge con in the sense of long-term durability. Whereas with leather, you could probably find a way to repair something in the field if really needed be, okay? The other thing is that the hardware on your kydex is still susceptible to the elements. So what that means is that the screws that are used in order to, you know, keep everything together in the sense of the retaining clips or whatever else it is that it utilizes to attach it to your belt, all that stuff is still usually made out of steel, and that has the ability to rust and eventually degrade over time. So that is still a consideration that a lot of leather holsters don't necessarily deal with. Yes, some will have things, like I said before, snaps or rivets of some kind, but generally, you're not going to be able to affect the overall functionality of the holster because of those things rusting or degrading. Whereas on the kydex holsters, very often the way that they attach to a belt is by an accessory that is attached by screws. And then that being said, those screws could eventually rust out or strip and no longer be functional in the sense of holding the holster itself to whatever it is that it attaches to your belt or other platform with. So that is something else to consider, okay? And when those things break, I mean, do you have extra screws with you? That's a possibility for you to maybe look into in the sense of having redundancy for your preps. Now, the other thing that kydex does bad compared to leather is that it's loud. When you holster and when you unholster, it makes more noise. And that's just something that you can't really avoid, but is that really gonna be a big deal if you're finding yourself in a situation where you have to unholster or holster a firearm, or if you have to take a knife in or out of a sheath? That's up to you, but in most situations, I don't think it will be that big of a deal. So unless you're worried about being completely stealthy and not being able to be heard, I don't think that's a huge con, but it is something worth mentioning, okay? So, what do I choose? What's my thought process and what's my opinion on the situation? Well, when it comes to choosing one type of material for long-term SHTF, I am still gonna go the route of kydex or polymer. And the reason behind that is because of its imperviousness to water, its durability and its ability to hold up to the elements, which I think you might be exposed to from time to time, its level of security when it comes to the retention of the knife or the firearm or whatever it is that you're using it for, and the fact that if worse comes to worse, and yes, you can't repair it in the field, I can easily carry something as a backup plan. And when I say that, what I mean is one of my bug out bags, I actually do carry a universal holster that is designed to just hold just about anything in it, that's very small, very low key, has a minimal footprint, doesn't weigh much, and it can at least do the most bare minimum basic job of the function if need be. But do I think I'd ever need to use it? No. But do I have it as a redundancy factor just in case the kydex holster breaks? I do. So do I plan for the idea that I might not be able to fix the kydex holster in the field and that it might fail at one point in time? Yes, I do. Do I have a way to figure that situation out that's not very invasive and doesn't require a lot of additional weight? I also do. If that wasn't an option, would leather maybe be a better choice? That's up to you to decide. But what I'm telling you is what my thought process is and how I think about these situations. And look, you can get extra hardware. So if you're worried about the screws rusting out and stuff, there you go, carry that, not much weight, easy to carry and easy to install if need be with the basic Phillips screwdriver. And guess what? Most people carry a multi-tool as well. However, if you're worried about just maintaining your ability to repair in the field and nothing else that we talked about before matters to you, then maybe leather's a good choice for you because of that aspect. But everything else, at least in my opinion, points towards modern polymers and things like kydex being a better option just due to the fact that in the elements and out in the open, they should be able to withstand for longer. And what I want to do really quickly here is actually read to you something I got off of 1791's website about leather care and what you should not do when it comes to a leather holster. And they make excellent holsters. You know, 1791 is a great company. And what I can say is that their do not do list here is one of the reasons why you might decide to go with kydex instead for this particular situation. Clearly, I own leather holsters and leather belts and leather sheets. I like them. They're beautiful and I enjoy wearing them. But I don't plan on them having to last me a lifetime out in the field. For those situations, I have things like this because of the factors we're going to talk about right now. So, leather care don'ts according to 1791, which is a great leather holster maker, okay? Do not leave your holster on the car dash or expose it to direct sunlight for extended periods of time, okay? Do not store your holster in the trunk of the car, an outdoor shed, the garage, or an attic. Do not submerge your holster in water or any other liquid, okay? Do not use mink oil, neat's oil, or leather conditioner, which will soften and distort the molding. Do not dry your holster with a hairdryer, radiator, oven, or laundry machine. And do not store your holster within reach of your dog who may mistake it for a rawhide chew. These are all do not do's on 1791's website. And when it comes to long-term SHTF survival, if you think you're not gonna be exposed to sunlight for extended periods of time, if you're not gonna have your holster in a place that has a similar environment as your outdoor shed or your garage, and if you think that you're not gonna submerge it in water ever, at all, for any reason, then maybe it's a good choice for you. But those things are all things I think about and say, I think polymer is really the way to go in this whole situation. So these are things I want you guys to consider. I do have, you know, leather belts that have years of use. I also have nylon belts that have years of use. And you can see the difference between the two belts, even though they're both starting to degrade. One has the hook and loop starting to fall apart, and the other one is getting, you know, different stress fractures and different bends in the leather in order to, you know, kind of maintain its purpose for my body. But what you can see from that is that anything you choose will eventually have some kind of degradation in the sense of, you know, getting beat up and being used over and over and over again and being abused in the sense of being exposed to the elements. However, there are things out there that might allow those items to be lasting a little bit longer with less maintenance. And that is something that I think for SHTF survival and dependability becomes very important. So I wanted to bring this to your attention, give you some ideas about what you should choose or not choose based on what it is you're trying to prepare for. And if you have any questions at all, leave it in the comments below. Here we can discuss what's happening, who carries what your thoughts are. You love leather and you think it's better? Tell us why down below. You're a Kydex person or a polymer person and you think it's the right way to go? Tell me why. And I love to have these conversations with everybody because it gives us all more to think about. And if you have anything else you need from me ever, magicprepper.com. And don't forget to check us out over on Patreon because we like to talk about other stuff related to things like holsters over there quite a bit. So if you have anything else at all, let me know in the comments below. But that's gonna be it for Magic Prepper.